You ever dreamed of becoming a king or president? Seems impossible since every square foot on Earth is already ruled by someone, right? Well, not quite. Here are some territories that don't belong to anyone, so they're up for grabs. Number 1. Knights resident at Fort St. Angelo. What better way to feel like a monarch than ruling a place with the words knight and fort in it? Now, this historic place is officially located in and owned by Malta, a small island country south of Italy. But you can sort of rent it if you want. As of 1998, it's being leased to the Sovereign Military Order of Malta for the next 99 years. Those guys, the Order, are basically a country, officially recognized by the way, whose only land is being rented to them. In fact, the Maltese government can apparently terminate that lease anytime it wants after the first 50 years, which would be as of 2047. So, I guess you could get in line to be the next tenant. On second thought, maybe this country would like to keep the only land it has. Let's see what other territories you can check out. Number 2. The Lagoan Isles. The Grand Duchy of the Lagoan Isles has nothing grand about its size. It's a micronation based on three islands in the middle of Baffin's Pond in Portsmouth, England. The idea to claim these lands as his personal duchy came to schoolteacher Lewis Robert Harold Stevens, aka Grand Duke Lewis, in 2005. He found out that these islands weren't officially mentioned as part of the United Kingdom, so why not rule them? The duchy has an official website where you can see the national flag, anthem, and even a list of public holidays. But the site hasn't been active for a long time, and the isles are uninhabited. If you don't mind being surrounded by ducks, you could become the next Great Duke of the Lagoan Isles. Number 3. Liberland. This is a virtual state between Croatia and Serbia about 2.7 square miles in size. The territory has been an unresolved subject of dispute between Croatia and Serbia since 1947, so in 2015, Czech politician and activist Vit Jedlička just came in and claimed this territory the sovereign state of Liberland. According to its official site, Liberland is a constitutional republic. The state has a president, Vit Jedlička himself, two vice presidents, five ministers, its own flag and currency, and even a motto: to live and let live. Ironically, nobody actually lives in Liberland, but you can apply for citizenship on the state site. By the way, you'd better hurry up. As small as the land between Croatia and Serbia is, there are others that could be moving in. The Kingdom of Enclavia and the Principality of Celestina, both also micronations, are currently disputing over territory near Liberland. Strange you don't hear about this stuff in the news. Number 4. Beer to Will. If you prefer a hotter climate, there's 800 square miles of unclaimed territory in northern Africa between Egypt and Sudan. Bir Tawal actually means tall water well. And you'll probably need plenty of H2O given that this place is an absolutely dry piece of desert. Kinda makes it sound a little less attractive to potential rulers looking for some property, but that didn't stop American Jeremiah Heaton for laying claim. In 2014, he named it the Kingdom of North Sudan and dubbed his daughter Princess of the State since, well, she'd always wanted to be a princess. Heaton actually went there and erected a flag in the territory. A year later, Indian businessman Suyash Dixit declared himself ruler of the Kingdom of Dixit, which, by accident or not, turned out to be the Kingdom of North Sudan. A couple of Russian tourists impressed by Tolkien's books also claimed this land to be Middle Earth and put a Russian flag there. None of these proclamations were recognized by anyone, so you have all the chances to become a ruler of the desert yourself. Number 5. Rockall. If you're a true highlander, then this piece of rock in the Atlantic Ocean might interest you. At just 56 feet high and about half the size of a hockey rink, Rockall doesn't seem all that special at first. There's never been fresh water on the islet, and its only residents stay there to rest during long flights. No, I'm not talking about frequent human flyers, but birds. In fact, Scottish politician William Ross is quoted as saying that more people have been to the moon than to Rockall. Sounds like a useless lump of granite out in the middle of the sea, right? Oh, but there's a lot more to it than that. Scientists say that there are tons of oil reserves in the continental plate beneath the rock, which makes Rockall the most appealing stone on the planet. It was claimed by the United Kingdom in 1955, but Ireland insists that it's Irish. While those two are arguing over who owns it, perhaps you can sweep in and lay claim to what Greenpeace activists dubbed Waveland back in 1997. They even offered citizenship to anyone willing to take an oath. Or, you know, you could come up with your own country name if you decide to occupy the rock. Number 6. Ailsa Craig. Here's another granite inlet in the United Kingdom, but you can actually buy this one. Ailsa Craig currently belongs to David Thomas Kennedy, a Scottish peer and the 9th Marquis of Ailsa, who's selling it for a mere £1.5 million, or about $2 million. The price was actually £1 million higher than when it was first put up for sale back in May of 2011. So you better grab it while you can. Yeah, let me withdraw $2 million. Be right back. Jokes aside, the dome-shaped island known as Paddy's Milestone is a pretty small territory of 220 acres with a ruined castle, a small cottage, a lighthouse, and a granite quarry on it. And if you are a curling fan, this should pique your interest. The rocks on Ailsa Craig are the main source of the majority of curling stones currently in use across the world. And you can't say this place is uninhabited since it's home to one of the largest gannet colonies in the world, with about 36,000 breeding pairs. The birds are closely looked after by the Royal Society for the Protection of Birds, so you'll have some strict visitors checking in on your avian neighbors. Number 7. Marie Birdland. Okay, enough itsy-bitsy islets and borderlands. Let's think big. What about the vastest no-man's land on Earth with a territory that's larger than France, Germany, Italy, and Great Britain combined? Hey, just check out Marie Birdland. Hopefully you don't mind the cold, since this place is an uninhabitable snowy expanse in Antarctica. If that's okay with you, then you must have been born to rural polar bears and penguins. Oops, polar bears hang out in the northern Arctic, don't they? Oh yeah, and you won't see a lot of penguins either. They only live on the coast. Well, still, you might assume you won't have any rivals on a territory with one of the harshest climates on the planet, but here's another surprise. In 2001, American Travis McHenry founded a micronation there and appointed himself ruler of the Grand Duchy of West Arctica. As of August 2018, the now protectorate of West Arctica has a population of over 2,000 people. The good news is none of them live there, and McHenry's claims aren't recognized by any government. So go for it, I guess. Number 8. The Moon. If Earth is simply not enough to quench your territorial thirst, then you should probably know that the moon doesn't belong to anyone either. And your chance to lay claim could be right around the corner, sorta. NASA, as well as the Russian space agency Roscosmos, have plans to return to the moon by 2020 and build a permanent base on the lunar surface. There are also plans for a manned colony by 2030, so it's high time you bought yourself a couple of acres for just £50, or about $65. Just see Sue and Francis Williams to make the deal. The couple have a company called Moon Estates based in Cornwall, England. They also offer land on Mars and Venus if you're in the market. They've already persuaded buyers to invest in more than 200,000 acres on Earth's lifeless satellite. Hey, you never know, we might be kicking ourselves in the future when those prices go sky high. Which of these unclaimed lands would you prefer to rule? Let me know down in the comments. If you learned something new today, then give this video a like, share it with a friend, and here are some more cool videos to check out from the bright side of life.